What up? Thank you guys for joining in today. I am BK back with another banger. Today I am answering a subscriber's question. They recently seen this video of mine that I uploaded, published 2 years ago. Studio One 4, how to set up MPC Live 2.0 with Studio One 4.0. He got lost in the information that I was given to him, something about the external devices, and I think I know exactly what it is that he got lost at. So I'm gonna revisit this video. Thank all 82 of you guys who thumbed the video up. Appreciate all three of you who thumbed it down within the last 2 years. Thank you for all 3,000 views that this video has gotten since May 29th of 2018. Do appreciate y'all, man. This cannot be done without you. All right, so let's get off into the MPC, into Studio One, so I can show you how to set this up. All right, so I got some things here on the screen already ready, because this is the second time that I'm recording this, because I thought it was capturing and it didn't, so I have to do it again. But luckily Studio One auto saves everything, so I was able to pull it right back up. So the first things first, ignore these three tracks here. This will be the MPC. It'll be here. It'll be set up like this. You all should know how to open up your VSTs by now. You open up instruments and you drag in your MPC. If I drag in a second MPC, it's gonna automatically tell me that I can't use it because it's already in use. So we delete that. Now you have this. You want to set it up the correct way. You go to what is called instrument output. You set instrument output to MPC Live, and instrument input, you set that to MPC. Now this becomes your external devices. So this is what the gentleman was saying, that he got lost. This step right here, he was not seeing the external devices. So again, you go to instrument output and you select your MPC. If you have an MPC Live, such as me, an MPC One, an MPC X, Ren, Studio, Touch, any of them, that's the step that you do. You change the instrument output to your MPC. Then the instrument input, you change it to MPC. When you hit the instrument tab, it pulls up external devices. All right, your next step would be create a new track, right? So you press T to add tracks, or you go to track and press add track. Now you change it from audio to instrument. Once you change it from audio to instrument, you can then press in input. You want to go down to your MPC and you change that to MPC channel one. Your output, you change it to MPC channel one. You can you label it whatever you want to label it. I technically do it one at a time, because I'm gonna show you, if you select ascending, everything that's named, whatever's named here, when you do this, undo that. When you select ascending and you put two tracks here, let's make it three tracks. All the tracks are labeled the same. They just add a number adjacent to it. All right. So I technically do it one at a time, but you can do it however you choose to. Okay, the next thing you wanna do is you wanna go back into the MPC after you set up your track. You open up your program. I got a drum program in here. You want to go to your edit. Scroll down to program, go up to note mapping, You want to change it from classic MPC to either C1, chromatic C1 or chromatic C2. The reason being is pad A1 triggers C-sharp 1 automatically. So if you go into your piano roll and you trigger C1, see, it's triggering C-sharp 1, sorry. It's triggering the kick. But what you want to do, the reason why you want to do that is because if you're playing from the piano roll inside of Studio One, you won't trigger it correctly. All right? So you want to change that from, you want to change the note mapping from classic MPC to either chromatic C2 or chromatic C1. The choice is yours. Whichever way you work best, that's what you do. You also can edit it from right here if you chose to. All right. So now that's all set up. The next step that you want to do is hit this down arrow. You want to go to pad mixer, which I was already on. You want to change. Each pad will be placed to program. You want to change it from program to either mono out from out 1 all the way to out 32, or stereo out 1-2 all the way to 31-32, right? If you want to mix a mono, you could put all your drum hits in mono, whatever works for you. Bang how you bang, right? And you go all the way down to however many pads you have sounds on. All right, once you have that set up, you then go to your instrument. I'm going to delete this MPC too because I don't need that. You go to your instrument, you hit expand. All of these will be off. It'll look like this for the first time. You want to select all your sounds. Well, all the pads, however many that you got. All right, once you got that, you can then, you know, add your insert effects all right here, okay? So, I already got some MIDI notes in because, again, I was recording this and it didn't capture. I'm hoping this one captures. It's nothing special, just something so you can actually hear it work. This is the kick, so you could solo this track if you wanted to. And I'm gonna color them differently. They're all here, and if you want to solo, mute. You can solo and mute them, right? If you want to do the other way, is the Studio One 4, you can convert part to pattern. So now that becomes the pattern editor. So if you work this way better, you can work this way. Convert part to pattern if you want to go backwards. So now we're back to the regular pattern editor. So that's pretty much it, man. I'm not sure if I missed anything. There was one other thing that I had mentioned in the other video. So say you was working inside of the MPC itself, right? Say you was working in here and And then now you could go into each individual track. And then right here where it says export MIDI, hit export MIDI. First one was the kick. And then now, so one thing that I want to point out, because I know the comment is going to come from someone who tries it and it doesn't work. So say you have your drums knocking, you know, you're inside of the MPC and you feel like, all right, I got the drums going. Let me go and open up a plugin. This is what happens if you're using it this way for some reason. So it completely knocks out the drum sounds. It's been this way since the first time I did the video. Yeah, I don't know why it does this. That's very weird to me. Yeah. So just keep that in mind. I'm not positive why it does that, but that's what it does do. So you'd have to work on your instruments, pianos or whatever synths inside of Studio One. All right. That's pretty much it for the most part, right? I think I covered everything that I covered in that other video in a faster time frame. I believe I did. I'll see once this recording stops, and then I gotta edit it down. So to the brother who needed that help, I hope after I edit this down and I publish it, I will email you the link so you can see it. And I hope this helps you. Anybody else who was caught in a rut and needed some guidance on that, I hope this helps you as well. If you have any comments or concerns, post it up in the comment section and I'll get back to you at my most earliest convenience. I do consultations, so you can hit me up on any of my social medias. The links are in the description, or my email is in the description area as well. This video is powered by Cookies, so please do hit that link in the description area. Help me help my daughter become successful this cookie season. I do appreciate you. She out banging on doors. I'm banging on your screens like, yo, what up? We got cookies. All right. Do remember that music is life. It is our DNA. Keep banging. Peace, love, and light. Till next time. Peace.